All right, everybody, welcome to another episode of the Ganas Network podcast. The energy drink has kicked in, and we are ready to get this show on the road.
Let's go.
Homero Guerrero here.
Pablo in the house.
Another wonderful Christmas time episode of the Lunes con Ganas. It is December 14th, Funday Monday. Here we are.
Less than a week. What is it, a week away from Christmas?
Is it? I don't even know, man. I'm just losing track. I haven't started Christmas shopping yet. I've been like nesting, and me and my daughter, my wife, man, I haven't gone out to the mall. I see posts about like parking at the mall's a bitch, and that they got in car accidents at the mall, and I haven't been to a mall yet, dude. What am I missing out on, Pablo?
Not a damn thing, except a lot of people running around and fighting for parking spaces and fighting for things at the mall that they want to get, I guess. I don't know. I try to do all my shopping online, so I don't have to deal with none of that. I think that's a smarter way to go, you know?
Yeah, 11 days till Feliz Navidad, man. Crazy.
So what do you want for Christmas? What are you asking Santa for,
man,
Christmas?
Man, I already have my healthy daughter, man. I couldn't ask for anything more than that, you know? And the wonderful part, I guess, is that I already have everything that I need. I have way too much clothes, way too many shoes. I have, you know, reliable transportation. My health is okay. I could afford to lose another 30, 40 pounds, but we're working on it. You know, my family's all good, man. I can't ask for anything else, man. The only thing I guess I would wish to ask of my family or friends is, you know, spending more time together. You know, but it's harder, you know, Pablo, as we're getting older. A lot of our friends have kids already.
You just kind of grow apart.
Yeah, and it's not a lack of wanting to spend time with somebody. It's just life gets, you know, life is happening in all of our lives.
Yeah.
And that's one of the reasons I like when I do like my birthday parties once a year, is because it's like a reunion of friends and we get to see old friends, and it's like, oh shit, I haven't seen them in like 2-3 years. But, you know, shout outs to all the friends out there hustling and spending time with their families. That's what's up. I think that's what the holidays is all about, you know, is spending time with your family. It's not even about the gifts that you get, or if you go on a vacation, good for you. And that's cool. Once I went to New York City for Christmas, and it was fun, but I was away from all my family. So at the same time, I was almost like, oh, I wonder, as I was in New York City, I was in New York City. I was thinking like, I wonder what my family's doing right now.
Really? Why would you think that? You're in New York City. I mean,
I know, but at the time it was at night. Once we did all the sightseeing, it was Christmas night. We're in the hotel room, and I was just like, oh, well.
So now what?
Now what? There's no tamales here. There's no Christmas tree in the hotel room. So, I remember we went to the lobby, and there were families and shit, like, you know, caroling outside because it was New York City.
Right.
New York City's like, you know.
I bet.
But anyway.
That's cool.
What do you want for Christmas, man?
You know, I'll be honest, man. Like, I have $500 in gift cards from Best Buy.
Woo! Shopping!
And the funny thing is, I go to Best Buy, and I don't know if I really want anything, because that's like, everything I could possibly want, I have. You know, like, I have iPads. I have laptops. I have TVs. Mm-hmm. I have, you know, everything that you can possibly. I mean, I got the coffee cup. Was it cake? The Keurig.
Yep.
I got the Keurig, I got the Ninjas, you know, the blenders. I mean, I got refrigerators, I got washers and dryers. I mean, I could say I'm blessed, so I don't know. I mean, I walked around, and I literally didn't know what to do with those $500. Yeah. You know, most people would love to have $500. Mm-hmm. But honestly, I mean, I'm just happy spending time with my family, too. I think it's all about spending time. So I'll be traveling and spending time with my family, and that's really all I can care about.
And I saw your TV, your post on Facebook about your smart TV. You're in the market to get a TV?
Possibly, yeah. Right. Is it worth it?
I don't know, man. Well, I personally like my TV, but we don't have cable or anything, so it's not like we get to, like, I used to drive my wife crazy because I would channel surf all day. I'd be like, click, 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 next, 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 next. And my wife would, after like an hour of that, she'd be like, okay, just fucking leave it on one channel.
That's what my wife does. Clack, clack, clack. I'm like, that's it. You're not allowed to handle the remote control anymore. That's it.
And
give it to me.
And now it's a little different. You know, we have a TV in our room, our bedroom, and in the living room. So she'll go in there and start, like, if she wants to watch something on Netflix. All we have is Netflix and Hulu. So she'll watch something in the bedroom, and I'm out here watching something else.
So you have two smart TVs.
Apple TV in her room, our bedroom. It's an Apple TV. It's a small, like, I think it's like a 40-inch TV. With an Apple TV. Apple TV is cool. We had that before the smart TV. It's essentially the same thing.
I think cable's kind of overrated. You pay for a lot of fluff in those channels, you know?
There's so much bullshit. I mean, all these European channels or all these, like, for people, For me, I mean, I speak Spanish, but do I need to have 20 or 30 Mexican shows? No, not really. And we all have only a certain number. I mean, I imagine people go to work, they come home, they're tired, they want to watch 2 to 3 hours of TV before they have dinner or before they go to bed, right?
Yeah. I streamline everything now. I use my iPads usually, and I just do Netflix, Hulu, Amazon Prime. That's, I mean, everything you could possibly want is on there. But now they got this new thing, the Fire Stick.
Yeah, where, my boy Vincent Din is convincing me to get one of those.
Yeah, you just got to, you know, have a friend that knows how to crack the code on that bad boy, and you can have, you can stream live TV. You can actually stream pay-per-view. So you don't have to pay for one of those Ronda Rousey 15-second fights, you know?
Or now McGregor.
Yeah, McGregor, 13 seconds. So, you know, I mean, maybe it's worth the investment. Plus, you can even catch some of them flicks that are at the theater. I'm thinking maybe it'd be worth the investment to get it now so you can watch Star Wars.
That's true. Vincent's been telling me about that for a long time. And I'm always like, he's super, you know, I don't know if it's the Asian in him, but he's always like a year or two ahead of technology from like me. I catch on way late. And I don't know. I would, for example, on that McGregor fight on Saturday, I would have been pissed if I would have paid, you know, $70, $80 for the pay-per-view. And the undercard fights are entertaining, sure, but everybody really wants to see that main bout.
Right.
13 to 12 second fight, I'd be pissed, dude. I'd be like, are you serious? $70 for just a few seconds, like that's insane. But that's just, you know, the world of MMA, you never know.
That's one thing I don't like about that sport is it's so unpredictable and it can literally end in seconds that at the end of the day you paid $50 to watch a fight that lasted, you know, 15, 30 seconds, and that's it. I mean, wow, that's faster than losing money in Vegas, you know? You spin the roulette, takes about 30 seconds, you know, before it lands on a number.
And that's the thing with the main fight. There are three rounds.
Right.
So here's the thing. If it goes 3 rounds, people are like, oh, that's whack. It went 3 rounds, right? There was no knockout. But then when it ends in 12 seconds, people are like, oh, that was whack. It ended too quick. It's like, no, you're never going to be satisfied. You're darned if you do, darned if you don't.
So maybe that's what I want for Christmas. Maybe I'll treat myself to that Amazon Fire Stick, and then I'll call my boy Vincent over to come and...
Hey, don't drop no names, bro. We don't know who's listening to
this.
Didn't
you just drop the name?
I didn't say he was doing that.
I didn't say last name.
Oh, okay. Vincent, no last name. Holla.
Hook me up, baby.
Yeah, and to each their own, you know, we all have all different forms of entertainment. I don't want you to think that I'm all work and no play because, you know, it's all about life balance. You know, for me right now, it's a lot of spending time with my baby, and she's getting big, dude. But, you know, I get home. What's the opposite of homesick? Sick of being home? Is that it?
There you go.
Sometimes right now, all I want to do is go to, like, the batting cages. I want to go and, like, swing the bat.
We should go, man.
That'd be fun, you know, and we go to the gym a few days a week. That's fun.
Yeah.
You know, but I can't wait for my daughter to get a little bit bigger. We're going to New York in April or May for her cousin's, Marisa's cousin's graduation.
You know, my wife and I were just talking about that. Our 3-year wedding anniversary is in April, and we're thinking of going out there for a week.
Ah, that'd be tight. Let's go.
What dates are you going?
I don't know. We'll talk about it after. But anyway, hope you guys are getting ready. This year it came by really quick, man.
Man, you're telling me.
It's crazy. This year went by too fast, and it's about getting ready for 2017. You know, I think for me personally, it's kind of looking back at the last 12 months.
Holy cow, you're skipping an entire year? You're just going straight to 2017?
Did I say 17?
Yeah.
Not bad, 16. Oof. Yeah, I'm already thinking about my daughter starting preschool.
This guy talks about the future, boy. Like no other.
No, just, you know, what have you done in the last 12 months? Where are you at? You know, I set some goals for myself last year, you know, to lose some weight, have some money in the bank, and, you know, pay off certain debts. And it's kind of good to kind of look back, see what you did, see where you fell short, and then plan, do, review, you know, make another plan and make some other goals. I think it's good to do 6-month, 12-month, 2-year, 3-year, 5-year goals, you know.
Yeah.
I don't like to plan out 10 years ahead because, to me, there's so much that could happen between now and 10 years.
Oh, yeah.
10 years ago, Pablo, I mean, I was 20 years old, just starting network marketing, you know, and making money, learning, though. That was the whole thing. And now, the person I am now. So I don't even want to imagine where I'm going to be by the time I'm 40. That's crazy.
Right.
'Cause I'm sure.
Yeah.
I mean, what about you?
Same thing. I think 10 years ago is when I started network marketing. And, you know, a lot has changed. I've gone from learning and going and investing and starting companies and losing money, making money, losing money, making money, But I mean, from every time I've lost money, I've learned something, a new skill, or a new thing to invest in, or just ways to manage and surround yourself with people who know what they're doing. You know.
Right. Because every day you're going to be faced with an opportunity to grow and learn. Is it's going to be a life lesson, or you know, what are you going to do with it? Yeah. And I know that throughout the last few years, you know, working in different jobs, different fields, I've learned a lot of skills. And the cool thing is that I'm still learning. Although I've managed to make a lot of money these last, like, since I was 16, 17, I had my own business. So I've been making money. But it's different when you're making money with on purpose versus, like, accidentally coming and making money.
Right. And there's always growing pains no matter what you're doing. So there's always going to be pain even when you're growing and your bank account's growing. There's still going to be some bumps along the road. But, I mean, that's just part of life. You got to keep growing.
Yeah,
you
I know.
You got to go through some bumps.
One of my things next year is I want to start learning Portuguese because I was thinking.
Why?
Why? Well, I thought it would be dope if my daughter not only spoke English and Spanish, but what if she could also learn Portuguese? That'd be pretty dope, you know. And
Japanese or Chinese.
The way of the future. I don't really care about like the Asian languages very much.
Why not?
For me, I'm more connected with the Portuguese. It's a European language, right? They speak it in Portugal and many parts of Europe. But the whole culture of speaking that language in Brazil, I just love it, man. And I think it would be dope just for my daughter to learn that. And there's a lot of business, especially financial businesses, that are expanding into Brazil. The financial market in Brazil is getting stronger. So I don't know. I just think it might come in handy later, especially when I watch, like, I listen to a lot of the Joe Rogan podcast.
Right.
And he has all these Brazilian jiu-jitsu guys. And it'd be interesting to kind of understand the lingo. And, of course, the wonderful Quetzal Guerrero. Yeah. We had him on the podcast a couple of episodes ago. A lot of his songs are in Portuguese, dude.
Oh, wow.
So it'd be cool to kind of understand what these songs are about.
Yeah. No, it makes sense.
But, yeah, as much as I do want to eventually visit Japan and all that, I don't really need to learn the language, dude.
So what are you going to use in order to learn the Portuguese? Rosetta Stone?
I think Rosetta Stone was a program, and
Vincent, I heard it's pretty good.
Yeah, Vincent used to use another one for him to learn Spanish, but it was pretty cool the way he would show him. But so I don't know. We'll see. Whatever programs I could download online for free at a very low cost.
Cool. Well, one of my goals for next year is to just become 100% straight e-commerce. Try to generate 100% of my income in my business just through online.
Online only.
Yeah. That's sales, awesome. Online sales, online lead generation. You know, I really truly want to do like 4-hour, 5-hour work weeks.
Tim Ferriss is a model.
Yeah.
Very dope.
Why not? Why wouldn't I? Yeah.
Yeah. I mean,
aside spend more time.
Yeah. Aside from making money, why do you see that as a major benefit? Streamlining everything through e-commerce.
Because it allows you to be able to do things that you can't do when you're 8 hours in a cubicle, you know, like
Right. Personally,
I want to be able to travel the world. The cool thing is when you travel the world, there's internet everywhere.
Right.
You can log in at the click of a button anywhere in the world and check on your sales and still draw money in so you can do what you love, which is travel for me.
Right.
And still generate an income.
Right. And that's cool. You and your wife could go to Greece. You guys can go to, where's the destination that you and your wife would want to go to?
We want to go to Greece.
Greece?
The Greek islands. That's one of the spots we want to go to. Spain is another spot we'd love to go to. I personally want to go to Japan or China. She doesn't want to go to China, for sure.
I'd pass
Japan,
on
she wouldn't mind.
Japan, for sure.
Yeah.
Osaka, bro.
But you know, one place I actually was thinking about, I think next year, I don't know during what time, but I do want to, now that Cuba is now a country we can go visit, I actually think I want to go visit Cuba.
I'd probably wait a little bit, bro. It's still a hot zone, man.
No, it's not, bro. It's not. I have a couple of friends that have already gone out there, yeah. And they say it's gorgeous out there, man.
Really?
They say like you're literally stuck in the 50s and 60s over
because
there.
Because of all the old classic cars is still original, right?
Yeah, so I think Cuba would be a cool spot to go check out.
Interesting.
Because not too many people can say they've been to Cuba because for a long time, nobody can go.
Like,
nobody can go to Cuba, you know?
Yeah, everyone's trying to leave Cuba.
Yeah, so I think that's one of the places I think
there
I
you go.
To.
So stay posted on Pablo's Facebook. We can see some pictures of him flying to Cuba. And be like,
eating
oh,
a Cuban
shit.
Torta.
Oh, that's right, dude. I wonder if they're really good or if it's just like the way they're done here.
Mm-hmm. Who knows?
I would just think of like finding some really good Cuban cigars, the special kind, and smoking a dope cubano on the
oh,
beach.
Yeah, for sure. That's a mandatory.
And some cafecito cubano. I think it's called a cafecito. Have you heard of that?
Yep.
When you go to these Cuban places in Miami and you ask them for a cafecito, it's literally this tiny little cup, almost like a little, like when you go to Starbucks and get like a shot or two, right?
Espresso.
But you drink it, it's supposed to be so like ridiculously strong, man, that you literally just got to take a few sips and you feel it right away in your blood.
I just heard a clip from Fluffy.
Uh-huh.
Did you see that clip?
Yeah, yeah.
Where he was asking for cafecito.
He's like, I'm not a cafecito.
Cafezote. Yeah, that coffee is pretty strong. Well, we've been to the one at Porto's. Porto's is a Cuban.
Porto's is bomb.
And that coffee is really strong.
Yeah, it was
so
good.
So I can't imagine what un cafecito is going to be like.
Well, get ready, man. You're gonna gain a few pounds out there.
Hey, man, it's all good.
That's why we're working out, right?
That's right.
We work out so we can pig out.
Mandatory.
We should make a shirt like that.
Salud.
I stay fit. Let's make a shirt like that. Work out so I can pig out. Oh, man. Gulp, gulp, gulp.
Yeah. But yeah, man, I mean, that's one of the goals is to generate, 100% income streams from e-commerce and be able to travel to a few places. Next year for sure is New York. I think New York's going to be one of the places
we'll see you there, brother. We'll see you there.
Then Cuba is one that I really am hoping I can sell my wife on.
I was going to say, is she excited to go to Cuba?
I have to sell her on it. But the one place I know for sure we do want to go is we do want to go back to Cancun. But we want to actually do Playa del Carmen.
Uh-huh.
Playa del Carmen,
yep.
Right?
Yep.
Yeah, that place looks a lot more cleaner.
Go to Oaxaca, bro. It's legit.
Nah, I'm good. I want to go to a resort, bro.
It's a resort.
In Oaxaca?
Yeah, it's where we went for our honeymoon. It's called Huatulco.
Oh, really?
The resort where we stayed at, it was all-inclusive on the beach. Beautiful, beautiful beaches. They're called Las Bahias. And all-inclusive, $105 a night. All you can eat, all you can drink.
Wow, that's awesome.
Sick resort, dude. It was so much fun. We want to go back. We're planning a big trip in 2017, so hopefully
nice.
You can tag along.
Yeah, why not?
Go to Aguascalientes, Guanajuato. But anyway, guys, get ready. How are you educating yourself or preparing yourself for the e-commerce?
You know what? Udemy. That's still one thing, one course that I'm, I'm constantly learning. I'm going over the drop shipping course again. Mm-hmm. Made $300 today in profits on just drop shipping at the click of a button.
What is drop shipping?
Drop shipping is where you buy from one store and you ship it to somebody who. So I'll give you a breakdown. Let's just say you have your own eBay store, right? You have an eBay store and you list a coffee machine, okay? You list the coffee machine, and let's say that same coffee machine, you find it at Sears.com, right? At Sears.com, it costs $79.99. But I listed it on eBay for $129.95. Well, what happens is the client usually will pay me first. So, well, actually, 99.99% of the time, they're going to pay me first. Mm-hmm. They pay me through PayPal. I get the money, and I use that money to buy the coffee machine at the Keurig machine at Sears, and then I have Sears ship it directly to the customer. And the difference between that is my profit. That's called drop shipping. You grab from one source, ship to it's legal, man. It's called
arbitrage.
So that's
David Boo's course.
Yeah. So I highly encourage everybody to, go on udemy.com and take that course. I mean,
yeah.
Honestly, you can make an extra couple $1,000 a month doing that. I mean, I know I've done it. My biggest month was about $4,000. I mean, and like I said, it doesn't take much to learn how to do it. You can buy that course for $200. No one else is going to teach you that kind of, mm-hmm. Skill for $200. So.
Yeah, and then you have those people that are going to be a little hesitant. They're like, oh, man, I'm going to spend $200 to learn how to sell on eBay. I already know how to sell on eBay, but it's not as simple as just selling on eBay. There's a formula
that has already been put together from somebody who's making multiple six figures from that. And another thing that I'm going to be doing is you and I are going to be creating some courses where we're going to teach people also how to make money online. Another thing is doing some day trading. Definitely want to step into that for sure. There's a lot of money to be made with currency, trading on currencies. There's tons of things I want to do. But honestly, I just bought two more courses on how to generate my own leads for anything. I mean, from selling T-shirts to selling my services with credit repair to, you know, finding leads that want to, for people who want to buy homes. I mean, I'm constantly looking for ways for me to educate myself.
That's and great.
That's the way you should be, because if you're not learning, you know,
you're dying.
Yeah, pretty much.
And how do you find time, man, to juggle all of these different things that you're doing, man? Because you're a man of different multiple cash flow streams. You know, how do you find time? Also, you're married, you know.
Oh yeah, you know, the cool thing is when you wake up usually a little bit earlier than most people, you're able to get a lot of that stuff in. You can get the workout done in the morning. You can come home and then start reading or take a couple of courses online, because they break them down into modules that are maybe 5 or 10 minute modules. You can watch two of them in 20 minutes and you learn a new skill. And then nighttime is, you know, for a lot of people is downtime, watch TV.
Right.
Well, for me, I use that to be online and learn and read on different subjects that can help me in some way, shape, or form. Because you know what? When everybody else is sleeping, that's your chance to get ahead of the competition, you know? Because you got to think, there's always someone out there better than you. There's always someone out there who is in the same industry and wants to grab a piece of your market share.
Right.
So you got to be up and try to be advanced as much as you can in technology so that you can be ahead of the curve, you know?
So even for people who are out there already making good money, they could always learn more and find these different sources to discover new avenues.
Yeah, because when a person thinks they've already reached the pinnacle, that's when you stop trying to learn a new skill.
Right.
But that's when you should say, you know what? If I've already mastered this craft, let me pick up a new craft. Because now you're going to allow yourself to compete differently and separate yourself from the competition because you've added a new skill or a new trade than your competition, and therefore you have an advantage now, you know? So you should always be learning. You should always be learning something, because someone's out there trying to take a piece of your market share. Always.
That's crazy. And that's good news, guys. The cool thing is that there's so much information out there. That's kind of something that we continuously repeat on this podcast, is that, you know, seek the information. You know, there's books, there's podcasts, there's Udemy courses, there's YouTube courses. And I was just brought attention to this other really cool program. If you guys want to look this up, just to kind of show you guys, I think, the future of education, it's called a masterclass. So go to masterclass.com and you guys could see, for example, there's a course that Usher teaches the art of performance. There's Dustin Hoffman, an actor. He teaches acting. Serena Williams teaches tennis.
What?
So, and it's pretty interesting. Christina Aguilera teaches singing. All these big famous people teaching specific things that they're experts in. That's the future of, you know, education. And I was reading a story a few days ago about the median income from college graduates from some of the most expensive and most prestigious universities in the country, in the U.S. And just a few that kind of caught my eye was USC. The average USC education is $62,000 a year.
Insane.
$62,000 a year is the median income. The average income of everyone that graduates from USC was $61,000 a year. So, man, people are going to school 2, 4, 6 years to get these degrees to go out and earn, you know, 60, you know, even if it was $70,000, like, how long, with the interest on those student loans, how long is it going to take for these people, number one, to get out of debt, and number two, to be able to provide a lifestyle for them to actually live a good life?
But even that, I mean, one of the scarier statistics out there, I think it's more like 70% of the people who graduate with a degree don't ever even use it.
Right.
You know, so, dude, you're going to throw away a lot of money. Yeah. And I'm not saying college is not a good thing. You know, it was definitely a cool experience for me, but it was an expensive experience that now that I look back, yeah, it gave me some kind of a foundation. But I could have picked up and learned a lot of these skills on my own, to be honest. Because like I said, I don't even work in the industry that I majored in. I went for computer science. After working 1 year in that industry, I was like, I can't work next to these people. It was just at the time, it was the when you thought of a computer science person, they literally were the ones that on the weekends or in the evenings, all they liked doing was playing video games, and I couldn't do that. Plus, it's an industry that's constantly evolving and changing, which means I was always going to have to study, always going to have to be up on game. And I don't have a problem with that. But the problem is that as you're learning and you're developing these new skills, because you got to stay, you know, sharp with and be current on, like, the industry, you don't get a raise with that.
Right.
You know? So you're always going to be learning. And sometimes you'll have to go back to school and get certified for a $10,000 a year bump. You know, I can make $10,000 a year on e-commerce, no problem.
Right.
And I don't have to worry about learning.
From home.
Yeah, from home. So, you know, that's the reason why, personally, you know, I mean, college is great. It's a great experience. I just think that they're straight up robbing us and a lot of the youth out there of a future, because they're all going to be in debt.
That's crazy.
High debt.
Yeah. And that's my baby in the background crying. We're at my house.
She's already letting you know she don't want to go to college.
Yeah, man. I can only imagine how hopefully the educational system shifts, man, because I can only imagine how expensive it's going to be by the time my baby girl is, you know, going to college. But you know, that's why we're going to get her this life insurance policy. And
yeah, so cash value.
By the time she's, you know, out of high school, have some money for her retirement by the time she wants to retire. But
you know, I know that there's a lot of people who think college education should be free. And just because other countries have it, that's great. But those countries don't have opportunities like here, you know? I think college education should have a price, but I don't think it should be overpriced. I think it should be even across the board. Right. I don't think you need to overprice or oversell a certain university just because of the name, you know?
Right. Well, it's a culture thing too, though.
Yeah.
Oh, I went to Yale.
Yeah.
Ooh, I went to Ivy League. USC. I went to.
They want an Ivy League name, you know, but right. That's so they charge that price.
Right. You're paying premium to go to those premium schools.
Right. And you know, let's just be honest. You know, some people aren't able to go to these schools because they don't have the finances, and they're able to go and get a degree from a smaller known university and be just as skilled,
right.
You know, and just as good as the person who graduated from USC. It's just the advantage, unfortunately, is given to the one from USC because. The name of the school, but you know, I don't know. That's just,
well, I mean, I have friends that went to like UCs. I have a friend that's an architect in Newport Beach for a really good firm. He went to Cal Poly Pomona, you know, not in a prestigious private school. It's a state school.
It's well known though. Cal Poly Pomona.
And I'm sure he's happy every day, you know, living the dream, working his career. And you know, that's another one I'd love to get on the podcast. He's a young guy and he's an architect. You know, he does these cool projects, but my whole thing, man, I think is whether it's self-education or traditional education, go and do something.
Right.
And if you're not happy with your results, you're not a tree, you can get up and move and do something else.
Right.
Too many people kind of get stuck in the mud of life. You know, you got to do a little different. If you aren't happy with your current circumstances or your situation that you're in, and maybe you not get it, it might not be easy. Maybe you have a mortgage and kids and it's not easy to just stop your job and do something else, but you can slowly part-time learn new skills, learn new crafts to kind of get you into a different career path.
Right. Like Jim Rohn says, you know, you work from 8 to 5, but from 5 to 9, you build your wealth, you know?
Yeah.
So you take advantage of those 4 hours. I don't, you know what? There's nothing wrong with binging on TV. There really isn't, because I enjoy doing it. I love watching series on Netflix, you know, where I can watch like, I don't know, 5 or 6 episodes at a time, you know? And I love it. Sometimes it's my escape from reality. Mm-hmm. But I also try not to, you know, get caught up in doing it every single day.
Right.
I like doing it maybe once a week, but I do. I also work, you know, that hard to say, you know what, I'm going to take 6 hours off to just be like in La La Land, or I'll go to the theater and watch a movie just to escape the worlds of, you know, the stress that comes with it. Because life is a stressful period, you know. But if you're going to come home and watch TV from 5 to 9 every single day, then you don't have the right to complain about how your life is currently, you know, the situation you're currently in, because you're not doing anything about it from 5 to 9.
Right.
You want to watch TV
or play video games,
then that's on you. As a matter of fact, I just bought an Xbox.
Yeah.
And I'm looking forward to it, because once a week on my downtime, I'll be able to enjoy some Madden. But I could not live my life around a video game, you know. I have nephews that, man, you can't get them out of the room because all they want to do is play games all weekend. And I don't know. I don't think that's the way. Even when I was young, I liked going outside to play, you know.
Right.
But nowadays, kids are just stuck in the, in the rut.
You know, over the weekend, man, I went to Home Depot to go buy a Christmas tree. And I saw like 4 little kids, different families. These kids are maybe 5 or 6 with glasses already, holding like tablets. Like, what the fuck is wrong with these, like, this generation of kids, man? Like, a parenting. It's not even the kids' fault. It's parenting. It's a parenting issue. But it's just, I know my wife and I, we want to be as, like, technology-free as possible. Not to say we're not going to have a TV, but we're not going to let her just play on an iPad or a phone all day. All these games are at a restaurant. They're sitting at a restaurant. They're playing on a tablet. No one's interacting with anybody. Everyone's on their own devices. Like, that's fucking heartbreaking, dude.
And, you know, like I don't have cable TV, you know, and I know you don't have cable TV. And ever since I cut out my cable TV, I'm more productive. I've generated a ton more money. You know, life is totally different because you can't. I mean, what are you going to sit there? Just look at a blank TV. And yeah, I am in the market for a smart TV, but that's only because I can streamline whatever I want on the weekends for when I'm there. You know, it's not something that I'm going to do every single day when I get home and watch the news and then, you know, watch my favorite shows. And there's a lot of crap on TV anyways that ain't worth watching. If you're not watching like The Prophet or Shark Tank, dude, you're missing out. That's a school on its own.
Yeah, crazy nuggets almost. You know? So there's good programming out there.
But I like smart TV. You know, I think smart TV would be a good investment because it already has Netflix, Hulu, and Amazon Prime built into it. Plus, you can surf the net if you want on there. But I'm not buying it just to say, hey, you don't want to watch cable TV 4 hours a day, because I can't do that. I find that I'm less productive when I had cable than when I don't have cable. How about you?
Same here, man. We've been cable free for like 2 years now, and just Netflix and Hulu for us. But for us, it's always like at the end of the day, you know. It's, or now we're home more, so we get in the middle of the day with the baby while the baby's sleeping. We'll catch a show, but it's life is a lot different, you know. We don't let it overtake us as far as like the TV stuff. But don't get me wrong, I do enjoy entertainment. I enjoy music, and it's just, you know, it can't all be work and no play. So for us, a little bit of Netflix, a little bit of Hulu, it doesn't hurt, you know. But what are you doing on the productivity time? I think that's the most important thing to kind of look at, Pablo, is how can we be more productive? You know, we all have 24 hours in a day. What are you doing with that time?
Right.
You know, and there's...
Wake up earlier.
Yeah, or get 2 or 3 or 4 jobs, right, Paul? But
Omero and I, we're gonna do something in the new year. I told him, I'm gonna call you out on it. So in 2016, 16. I'm giving him at least 2.5 weeks notice. Oof. So I'm telling him that if we can both be up and at the gym by 5:30 in the morning, we usually put in about 1 hour and 20 minutes, so we'd be out of the gym by 7 a.m. How much more can we get accomplished throughout the day?
I'm already yawning just thinking about it.
He really is. But this is a challenge to him. But, you know, I think if we hold each other accountable, I think we can do it. There's a book called The Miracle Morning. It's a great book, great information, great story. The guy who wrote the books, it's an amazing story. You got to read it. But I'm challenging Omero so we can wake up earlier and try to be more productive. I mean, I know him and I, we make money together. How much more money can we make like this, right, Meryl?
Yeah, man.
You know, how much more can we get done? How much more can we learn?
Right.
You know?
Yeah, I think we definitely got to make that happen. And I definitely accept the challenge, man. I know you're going to be out of town for New Year's, but when you get back, it's on and cracking.
No, I'm not going to be out of town for New Year's.
Oh, just Christmas.
So we start January 1st.
Oh, snap, January 1st. Get ready, guys, when we get back on the podcast after New Year's. How much it kicked my ass is, there's no doubt that whether I'm doing it or not, it's just a matter of getting in the rhythm of doing it.
Correct.
And staying healthy so we can continue to do it, not overkilling ourselves at the gym with Jamie Sandoval.
Yeah, shout out to that guy, man. That guy killed my legs.
God, he jacked us up. I was sore for like 3 or 4 days.
Oh, man, I couldn't walk. I couldn't take a dump. I couldn't.
But they say no pain, no gain, right? Yeah. Oh, dude, another thing too. Did you see Eric got hurt? Our friend Eric Duran got injured.
Oh, yeah, he got injured.
I want to say...
Hey, man, get better, bro.
Yeah, I want to say during one of his workouts, he got hurt, and he's going to be out for a few months. He's not going to be able to do the LA Marathon.
I know, that sucks.
I'm sure he's really bummed out, man. That guy's been training so hard all year, so get well soon.
We're rooting for you. But, yeah, so anyways, I think as for me, you know, I'm looking forward to the challenge of 2016. My goal is to make 2016 my bitch and, you know, have fun while I'm doing it, you know, and do some joint ventures with some friends and generate, you know, crazy income and be be able to travel more. And, you know, that's pretty much it for me.
It's going to be
pretty stoked.
A big year, man.
Anyways, Christmas is next week.
Next Friday is Christmas. We are going to have a podcast next Monday, the 21st. So stay posted next week. We're going to share some more information on how we're going to close out the year. And perhaps a book that we're going to all read. What was the name of that book?
Miracle Morning.
All right, guys. So if you guys already heard that, if you guys want to order that book, I need to order it. I don't have it. The Miracle Morning. And what is the name of the author, Mr. Perez?
I'm pulling everything up right now.
So the whole thing is it would be cool. Pablo and I, a couple years ago, we were part of this mastermind group where we would meet. It was once a week, and we did like a book of the month thing, and we would, you know, it's kind of like an accountability group. We're not going to get in too deep with that, but it would be dope if we did at least like a book of the month, you know, to kind of say, oh, this is the book that we're reading. And if you want to kind of follow us and read the same book, like, pretty cool, because we'll be discussing it on the podcast, I think, whatever nuggets we get out of it. So The Miracle Mile.
No, The Miracle Morning.
The Miracle Morning.
You're thinking about the movie.
Oh, okay.
So anyways, it's written by Hal Elrod. It's on Amazon.com right now. You can actually buy it for $17.96. If you buy it on the Kindle, I believe it's like $13. But there's a bunch of Miracle Mornings. There's one for realtors. There's one for business owners. Like, there's a different... I mean, he's got... I mean, because the guy's he's a millionaire, you know? So he's teaching a bunch of people different tactics depending on the industry you're in. I say just start with the Miracle Morning, the not-so-obvious secret guarantee to transform your life. It's got 1,381 reviews, and it's 4.5 stars. Number one bestseller. So I think you guys should go pick that book up, including you, Omero.
Yeah, and I will. I'm going to order it. I've already been listening to his podcast since you mentioned it. If you guys are listening to other podcasts and if you want to get some nuggets, this guy's pretty good. It's a pretty cool podcast. It's called Achieve Your Goals with Hal Elrod. I'm on episode 15. And they're only 30 to 45 minute podcasts. So I'm sure that if you wanted to get on that as well, same author, I'm going to definitely order that book, man, and get ready and start reading it in January. Along with those 5:30 a.m. workouts, man. And it's going to be big, guys. And you guys could, you know, check our progress and kind of help keep each other accountable.
Bam. So look forward to, you know, sharing, you know, some more stuff with you guys next week. And, you know, make sure you guys go out and order that book. As for Omero and I think we're ready to sign off.
All right. Yeah, that's going to be it, man. We'll see everybody next week. If you haven't already done so, please go to iTunes. Leave a really cool comment, review, 5 stars. Let us know what you think about the podcast. Let us know if there's anything else you'd like to hear.
Lunes con ganas.
Lunes con ganas, everybody. Shout out to our sponsors, Metro Fund Financial. Thank you for the continuous support. They're one of the credit repair specialists in the nation, in the U.S. The cool thing is whether you live in California, Florida, or Georgia, they can help you.
New York, no matter.
They don't discriminate based on your demographics. So give them a call. Visit the website, MetroFundFinancial.com.
Yep.
And second sponsor, J&R Landscape, J&R Landscape. We do residential and commercial landscaping, so give us a call. Visit our website, jrlandscape.co. All right, guys. You guys make it a great week. Lunes con ganas. Push, hustle, grind. Get it.
Bam.